Welcome back to Agates Explained by Josh. Today we are talking about flow channels. They're probably one of the most discussed feature in Agates overall, and I'm extra saying only flow channel because the regular terms we would be using is either inflow or outflow channel, but I want to keep it neutral because there's so much discussion going on, and while I feel like it's very obvious if it is a flow channel that's going in or out, some other people might disagree. So I'm keeping it neutral, and I'm going to show you the first piece directly, which is a Mexican Laguna agate, and just to show you what actually I mean by talking about flow channel, and that means that in pretty much every single agate you will be able to see a channel that leads from the inside of the stone to the outside of the stone. So here I'm giving it away, I would call it an outflow channel. But it's actually not an outflow channel, but more like a pressure release channel from the empty cavity. So you can imagine agates form under high pressure, and there's probably some kind of vacuum inside of the nodule while it is still in kind of a liquid viscous state, and sometimes it will be like a needle point, pinpoint, that like releases the pressure. In some pieces you can see it like an entire ridge going across the stone. Here's another example to show you what I'm talking about with flow channel. You can see also here from the center in this Patagonian agate, it pushes the banding, you know, kind of outwards. Like if it was an inflow channel, you would see the banding being pushed in the different direction, but since the banding is pushed outwards, it has to be that the banding is forced from the inside to the outside of the stone. A lot of pieces will also have several different outflow channels heading in different directions as well, so you can see that it actually has to be have formed under some kind of pressure, either in a vacuum or like an overpressure within the nodule, because otherwise you would have a pressure release only towards one direction. Because of gravity, it would either probably go to the upper side of the stone, because the gas is lighter than the actual viscous silica fluid that's inside of the stone, and it would move just up. But since it's under pressure, it will move in different directions of the stone wherever it can find an exit point. So here's another beautiful Chinese agate which has this tiny, perfectly needle point exit tube, I will call it in this case, because it's not like a ridge, it's really just a pinpoint exit. And here I explained it in a different video earlier, you can perfectly also see the color change at the very edge of the stone, which has been created by secondary liquid that used the original exit channel, but then it might have been reused for an entry channel. So it's all kind of confusing, but I think that might explain it in this case. Here we have another beautiful agate from Agate Creek in Australia, and also here you can see there's a kind of tube that shapes the band towards the outside of the stone. This one also kind of looks like one of the extinct kind of birds that have like a really big head. So I think that's a really cool piece as well. This is really interesting. Actually, the next two pieces are really, really interesting because they kind of show you another point. Here at the outside of the nodule, I will show a close-up of this one as well. You can see the opening of the exit tube is still visible from the outside of the nodule. And when we turn it around and see it, you can see that this is actually where the escape tube formed from the center of stone moving out, and here you can actually see it where it left the nodule, which is maybe like 4 millimeters away from where you can see it's already trying to form the exit tube. So really a three-dimensional piece to just see it a little bit more obvious in this case. And in the next piece you can see it even more, and in this case it's actually more like an entire pressure ridge. And what I realized is that in most cases the exit tubes will be from one of the furthest away point at the nodule. So here you can see at the Malawi agate I was showing earlier, it might have been like a tip that formed exactly where the broken off part is, where you can see the exit tube right now, but it's broken off. But like in perfectly round Chinese agates, for example, you cannot predict where an exit tube is. But a lot of times when I cut the stones, I can predict it by looking at like a small kind of tip that's like at the nodule. That's most of the cases where you will find one of the tubes. Here in this polyhedroid agate from Brazil, long mined out in the 1970s, you can see at the outside already the openings of the escape channel. It's like a ridge on, at the entire corner, also at the furthest away part of the nodule. It might have more escape areas here at this ridge as well. You can even see it like with a little hint if you look deep inside of this chalcedony that there's another escape ridge going in that direction. So I believe there's another escape area over here. Here in this area, it really looks just like tornadoes, like heading inside or outside of the stone. And in this case, they have also not been entirely filled with agate again, but they have been left empty. And also, if you look closely here where the tornadoes are ending, you will see that every single tornado will actually have like a tiny opening in this piece. In this one, I'm showing just for fun because you cannot see any escape tubes in this one or any tubes at all. But I'm sure this agate will have some as well, so I'm not going to cut this one up, but I bet if I cut it further in this direction or in the other half, if it would have been cut up into slices at some point, you would definitely be seeing one of the tubes, because that is how the color has formed inside of the stone. I hope you enjoyed this kind of information on tubes and infill, exfil, traction channels, or whatever you want to call them, and I hope you'll be back for the next video. Thanks for watching.